Creating a good video game is not an easy feat to achieve. It takes a lot of effort and time, and often a ton of money as well. But most importantly, it takes good tools that artists and studios can use and rely on to bring their visions to life. If you are someone who plays video games but doesn't have a clue what kind of 3D software are used to create them, then in this video, we will give you a quick overview that will help you understand the process and know more about the 3D software that are commonly used to work on video games. Autodesk Maya. Autodesk Maya is probably the most used 3D software when it comes to professional 3D modeling and animation for video games today. AAA studios around the world use it to work on the best video games in the market because it offers a good balance of what game development artists need, like modeling, UV and wrapping, baking, rigging, animation, and so on. Of course, no 3D software alone is enough to fill the needs of the whole game development pipeline in just creating game assets, let alone making a complete playable video game. If you are solely interested in making video games, Autodesk also offers Maya LT, which is a version specifically created for indie game developers who can't afford the full price of the full package. Maya has good modeling tools that allow game artists to create everything necessary inside a video game, such as character, game props, environments, and so on. Also, what makes Maya a good option for making video games is the fact that it is excellent when it comes to rigging and animation, which is very important in this industry. Big studios such as Naughty Dog rely on Maya as an essential part of their pipeline, as they have worked on some of the most iconic video games of the last decade, such as Uncharted and The Last of Us. Autodesk 3ds Max. 3ds Max, I would say, is probably the only 3D software in the game development industry that can compete with Maya because it has been an essential part of many game creation pipelines for a very long time. And during that time, it became better equipped for this type of work. 3ds Max has good and easy modeling tools, UV and wrapping, baking, and animation tools, as well as Maya, because they are currently developed by the same company known as Autodesk. But I would say that Maya is superior to 3ds Max in terms of animation. Generally speaking, 3ds Max can be very good for modeling different things that can go into video games, like characters, game props, vehicles, and so on. Notable users of 3ds Max in the video game industry are Ubisoft Studios, that used it pretty much on all the Assassin's Creed franchise, which is known for rich environments and good animations as well. Also, Deus Ex, in which the team at Eidos Montreal used 3ds Max to create the world of Deus Ex, from its characters to its extensive environments. Blender. Even though Blender is not part of the AAA industry when it comes to video games, it is an important part of the indie development world. This is the case because it is a professional 3D software that can do pretty much everything that 3ds Max and Maya can do, in addition to having additional features. And this is all for free. That's why indie developers or those with a limited budget find Blender to be a very good choice. It can be good for modeling, UV and wrapping, sculpting, painting, rigging, animation, and so on. Blender in particular is getting a lot of momentum lately with the release 2.8 and beyond. This led many artists, whether they are beginners or professionals, to give Blender a shot, in addition to medium and indie studios using it more and more. Motto. Motto is also a good option as a 3D program in game development pipelines. It is a good tool to create and prepare assets and environment props for any game engine. The modeling tools are good and easy to use and can be edited and integrated into any workflow. In addition to that, it has sculpting tools and the ability to handle high-res meshes efficiently. There are many tools to model quickly both high and low poly models for any asset you want to create, then create efficient UVs and baking later on. Even though Motto is a very good tool for creating assets for video games, it is not as popular in the game development industry like 3ds Max or Maya is, except probably in making indie video games. Houdini. Houdini can also be a good 3D package for video game developers, but it is not used the same way that 3ds Max, Maya, or Blender are used, because the procedural approach that Houdini offers can be a good way to create procedural assets and environments before reaching deadlines. side effects, the developers of this program offer Houdini Apprentice, which is a free version for non-commercial use. Houdini for the most part is used by indie developers, but some big studios such as Ubisoft began using it lately when they created the large-scale environments for some of their video games, in which they relied on it as a primary tool for creating large-scale environments with all its natural elements such as roads, villages, rivers, vegetation, and so on. In addition to this, Houdini is a fantastic 3D package for creating game cinematics because, after all, it is an excellent program for VFX, and this is what it is used for in the first place. Cinema 4D. Cinema 4D is another famous 3D package that can do many things and can satisfy most of the needs of game artists working on video game assets for their projects, from modeling, UV unwrapping, rigging, animation, and so on. Even though generally speaking it is less known for making video games, it can be a good option for making indie games, especially if you are doing it as a hobby or something on the side. I mean, if you're not interested in working in big game studios as a primary goal. ZBrush. ZBrush is widely used in the gaming industry for high-poly characters and sometimes for architectural or environmental stuff, because Maya and 3ds Max are not equipped with sculpting tools that allow artists to capture the details necessary when working on complex and highly detailed characters, especially animals and all different types of monsters. The primary function of ZBrush is sculpting, but also it does UV creation and retopo too, and there are good tools that are usually used at this stage. I don't think that two professional 3D artists can disagree that ZBrush is the absolute go-to sculpting tool, especially when it comes to complicated projects, because it is specialized and has been leading the industry for so many years now. But there are a few software worth mentioning in this category, such as Modbox, which is also a good sculpting 3D software from Autodesk. It was originally developed as a tool of adding high details to creatures for the film industry, later found its way to game development, but it is not widely used as ZBrush is. You can also use Blender, which has good sculpting tools that you can rely on to create your game assets. In addition to that, there is a free sculpting software called Sculptress from Pixelogic, the developers of ZBrush. It can do a decent job, but it is nowhere near ZBrush, because I believe it has not been updated in recent years. But it is a nice option nonetheless. Substance Painter. Substance Painter is industry standard when it comes to PBR texturing and painting, which is a crucial part of game development. I would say that this painting program kind of revolutionized and changed pipelines of the majority of game development studios and artists working in other fields as well. The thing is, 3D software such as Maya and 3ds Max are good for modeling, but when it comes to baking, texturing and painting, they are lacking compared to what 3D artists and studios would like to have, especially with the availability of specialized tools such as this one. Substance Painter is a one-stop shop for all the needs of painting and texturing for game artists. It is possible to bake a high-poly model you made in your 3D package onto the low-poly model. Also, you can paint intricate details, add masks, layers, you name it. I would say that Substance Painter is now the ZBrush of texture painting in game development, because it became an essential part of many studios' pipelines and it has been used for many great titles such as Days Gone, Assassin's Creed, Spider-Man, Death Stranding, Gears 5, The Last of Us 2, and much more. Mari. Mari is also a texturing and painting program, but I would say it is more dominant in the VFX industry because it allows artists to create super high quality textures up to 32x32K, which is definitely not going to be needed in making video games. This software is powerful and has been around for a long period of time. One of the notable examples of Mari being used in the gaming industry is when Ready at Dawn Studios used it to work on their video game called The Order 1886. The work they have done is fantastic, and it proved that Mari can be used to do good painting and texturing for video games, not only for VFX work. Quixel Suite. When using Quixel Suite, the interesting thing, you don't have to leave Photoshop if you have been using it for a very long time, especially if you have a background of texturing and painting in Photoshop for video game assets. Quixel Suite comes with Undo Painter, Dedo Painter, and 3D Baker. It allows you to create normal and PBR textures inside Photoshop. Undo Painter is used to create the normals and add details to them in a nice and quick way using Photoshop tools. Dedo is a PBR texturing tool that allows you to create final textures quickly. It is artistic and allows you to create high quality game assets. 3D Coat. It is a modeling and sculpting software, but it can do a good job for texturing game assets. For the most part, it has a good tool set for painting tasks. Also, it has a tight interaction with Photoshop, which makes it a good program for working on game assets. I hope you found this video useful and informative. If you have something to add, please leave it in the comment section below. Also, you can check some of our previous videos. Thank you very much, and I'll see you in the next one.